Welcome back, Waltham High, for another edition of WHS News. I'm Colin.
And I'm Derek. We have a huge array of segments to roll this week. But first, Colin, how was your snow day?
It was great. I earned some money putting in hard work for my neighbors shoveling snow.
Well, speaking of hard work, Andrew and Ryan put in a lot of it to bring you their Super Bowl recap. Let's check it out.
Denver started off Super Bowl 48 with a bad snap. He was still a 2-point lead and also set the record for the fastest time scoring at 12 seconds. Shortly after, Seattle's Percy Harvin had a 58-yard run, putting Seattle in place for their first touchdown in the game. Broncos yet again choked and Seattle intercepted the ball, leading to a second touchdown in the game for Seattle. Shortly after, Seattle capitalized on another interception and ran it in for a touchdown, this being their third. Later in the second half, Percy Harvin, again, had another touchdown run. Denver soon fumbled the ball after this, and Seattle capitalized, picking it up. Seattle would score yet another touchdown. Denver would finally get their first touchdown at the end of the third quarter. To close off the game, Seattle would get one final touchdown, leaving the score at 43-8. Seattle's decimating Denver Broncos.
That was a great game.
Yeah. Even though the Seahawks won by so much, I still watched the whole game, especially the commercials.
Since the commercials were so enjoyable, Derek and I covered that in this week's segment. Let's check it out.
What was your favorite Super Bowl commercial?
The Budweiser one with the dog and the horse.
Being a guy from the 80s, I'm going to have to say the Radio Shack commercial.
With the puppy and the Clydesdale, I really liked it. Really felt that.
Probably the Maserati one. I like that one a lot.
I didn't really catch too many. I was too busy stuffing my face with chicken wings. So,
do you think they're effective?
Yes. It was cute.
Yeah, I think so. It creates a little bit of a buzz the next day. You guys are talking about it. We're talking about it now, so I think it makes it effective.
Definitely.
Yeah, I mean, everyone watches them.
I mean, I guess so. I mean, if they make me laugh, I'm probably going to buy whatever it is, so as long as they make you laugh.
And how much do you think it costs for a company to run an advertisement for 30 seconds during the Super Bowl?
A million.
It's double that.
Oh. No.
Okay. Have a nice day.
Think or no?
I hear it. No.
I hear it's 4 million.
That's correct.
4 million.
Johnny Retail.
You're correct.
You know the answer to this. Johnny Retail tells us every year it's 4 million for a 30-second slot.
I have no idea. If I had to guess, probably there was a voice crack in there. We'll just not worry about that. But if I had to guess, probably about 1 million for a 30-second slot. So.
It's actually 4 million.
Yeah. Impressive.
Oh, thank you. Nice job, Derek.
Thanks, you too, bud.
So what are you doing this weekend?
Probably going to get some stuff to wear to the Valentine's Day dance.
Well, Danny and Ben found out about it in their segment. Let's check it out.
Face off. Go.
When is the Valentine's Day dance?
February 13th, next Thursday.
Where is the dance being held?
At the Waltham High School Auditorium Foyer.
Who's invited to this dance?
It's seniors and juniors only.
What's going on at the dance?
So it's from 7 to 9:30. It's semi-formal. It's just a way to get the juniors and seniors to communicate and have fun, you know? Dance, communicate, have fun. That's what it's all about.
The Valentine's Day dance.
Yeah, you guys just told me about it.
Are you gonna go to it?
No, probably not.
Why not?
It's not my thing.
Do you know about the Valentine's Day dance?
Yes.
Are you going to go to it?
Of course.
Are you excited about it?
Yep. I love Valentine's Day. I love to dance, so, you know, put together, it's a really good thing.
Do you know about the Valentine's Day dance?
Yes.
Are you going to be attending?
Yes, I'm very excited.
What are you looking forward to during the dance?
Dancing. And food. Drinks. And drinks.
Do you know about the Valentine's Day dance?
Yes.
Are you going to be going to it?
Yep.
Are you looking forward to it?
Of course.
What are you going to be looking forward to?
Dancing, eating.
You can also get Valentine's Day carnations in the senior house office. I think it's 3 for $1, 6 for $5, and 12 for $10. It's a way to get a carnation for a friend or a secret lover, you know.
I like it when the school adds new activities to make the school year more interesting.
This week we did the same thing in TV. We added a new weekly segment, Vocational Program of the Week.
Let's see what it is.
How much time do you spend in your print shop class a week?
14 periods a week.
What is your role in this class?
We create, design, and print for all schools around, all elementaries and preschools and high school here.
Thank you.
No problem.
What is your class all about?
So I teach multiple classes here. I teach Graphic Design 1, Graphic Design 2, Digital Illustration, and Advanced Placement Design. Essentially, they're all about learning about graphic design and digital illustration as an art form and as a potential career choice. So we go into creating everything from business cards, letterheads, CD covers, posters, magazine pages, what else? CD covers, toy package designs, pizza boxes, stuff like that. We teach you how to create it in an art sense, but also in a proper design sense, so it prints properly.
How significant is it to other classes?
Well, it's significant to everything. I mean, we tie in every class. We do a lot of writing. We use a lot of math. But I think as it ties in specifically to the vocational program, is it ties into the graphic communications class. Our graphic communications teaches printing, and we're the related part of it. So we teach graphic design specifically for print. So we make sure that not only do designs look great, but they also print properly.
Is there anything special you would like the viewers to know about the class?
Yeah, there's a lot of special things about the class, actually. It's a great class. If you're a creative person and love to draw, this will be a great class for you. If you're a creative person but don't like to draw, but you like to make stuff, this will be a great class for you. If you're a very creative person who just likes to use computers, this will be a great class for you. It counts as both either a practical art or a fine art. So you could take it as a fine art and really focus on the art side of it, or you could take it as a practical art and really learn about the career side of it. So there's quite a lot of special things. And we have a great classroom. We have a lot of computers, most of them brand new, all running CS6, which is the newest, a year late now, but one of the newest programs out there that are being used throughout the world, so we're industry standard. We have a big classroom. We have one side is all computers. The other side we use paints and markers and colored pencils. So it's a great great place. Yeah.
Nice work, boys.
Colin, you gonna go to see Dance Theater this weekend?
Yeah, definitely. It's one of the highlights of my year.
Brendan and Anisco did their segment on DT. Let's check it out.
Okay, what is Dance Theater?
Well, Dance Theater is a unique dance concert to Waltham Senior High School. It is a 29-year-old tradition at this high school. And it features jazz, tap, hip-hop, lyrical, contemporary, solos. It's so much fun. It's various genres of dance and about 100 people performing these numbers.
How's Dance Theater so far?
It's pretty good. It's really fun.
It's pretty great. Awesome.
And was it hard preparing for it?
Yeah, Deb's crazy, so. Yeah, a little bit, but overall it's worth it, so.
Well, for guys, yeah, a little bit, because we don't have the most experience and we don't take classes, unlike the girls, which do.
And can anybody join Dance Theater?
Anybody can be part of it. There is an audition process because it is a dance concert. A musical might have a chorus with actors and dancers, so you really have to dance to be in the show, but if you have technique, you can tap, you have a little special skill, then your odds are better for making it. But I try to take a fair representation of 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th grade, and a fair representation of people with different styles. But this is a beautiful thing about theater. There's a place for everyone if you want to be involved. We have stage crew, we have light crew, sound crew, graphics, if people like to make posters over here, costumes. There's a way to get involved with dance theater if you truly want to be part of the experience, even if you're not like a dancer. Look who happens to be coming down the hall. What a coincidence. Here they go. Let's see a commercial for dance theater right now, live. Go, boys, go. Give me that. Go back, go, go, more. Give me that. Give me that. Give me that. Give me that.
Yes. How is dance theater going so far?
To be honest, it's going pretty good. You know, it's fun and stuff. Like, you meet new people and stuff, and yeah, it's fun.
Dance theater's pretty good. You can make new friends, learn new dances, get the girls.
And what's the hardest part about preparing for dance theater?
Like, learning the new dances and stuff, because, like, she kind of teaches it fast, so we just have to, yeah, you have to get it quick and stuff. So, yeah.
Hardest part would be the dances. I mean, it takes time. Yeah.
And what are the shows?
Shows are tonight, Thursday, and Friday, February 6th and 7th at 7:30. And because it snowed yesterday, we have a Saturday show on the 8th of February at 2 o'clock.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome. Dance theater.
Wow. Dance is one beautiful art form.
Speaking of art, our very own Juan and John covered the school's art courses.
Yeah, let's see what they have to say about that.
What qualification do you need to become an art teacher?
You don't always have to be a good drawing and painting person. Most are.
By the way.
4-year college. Within that, there's studios, academics, a lot of art history. And then, nowadays, to be a teacher, you would like to also have your master's, which is a requirement.
There's a lot of different classes, so you can either take the 2-period art class, and then you can take advanced art, 4 periods. I'm in portfolio preparation, so that's preparing you for your portfolio that you have to send into colleges, and then there's also AP Art.
The art program has a lot to offer. We have a wide variety of classes that we can that you can take. There's 2-dimensional drawing and painting, stained glass, photography.
Well, I like the freedom in art and just that you can kind of do whatever you want, and that everyone's style is different.
It's a great place to come and have an outlet. It breaks up the schedule of the academic day, which is fairly grueling.
Man, I wish I could draw.
Hey, maybe you should sign up for art next year to learn.
Yeah, I guess, but my heart lies in the TV studio.
Well, if you wanted to change your mind, maybe you should watch this segment on course selection this week.
What is the history of Waltham class?
History of Waltham class is a class that was started by Mr. Cox back in 1981. It's a local history class, which is very unique. Not too many high schools offer a local history class, especially on its city or town. It's about the rich history of Waltham. Waltham has many firsts. The American Industrial Revolution started in Waltham at the Boston Manufacturing Company, just off of the Moody Street Bridge. So we take a look at the colonial period in Waltham and the Federalist period and the Industrial Revolution. And then we go on to other things. We look at architecture of Waltham. There are many different architectural styles in Waltham. We look at leisure time in Waltham. It's an exciting class. If you take the honors section, you get Mr. Cox, he's the one who designed the class. And most likely, if you take the C1 class, you'll get me.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
So we have a couple new classes next year. One in the math department. It's an intro to computer science class.
There's also actually another one in the math department that integrated math that you guys took as two periods a week is now becoming a four-year elective class. There's also a stress management class that's being offered. And then I think those are the top three new classes. There's a couple classes that we're getting rid of. We're no longer offering the four-period a week image writing class. It's now just a two-period elective. It's not being offered four times as an elective anymore. I think that's it for new classes.
So it depends on what grade you are in. Freshmen are meeting with their guidance counselors next Monday and Tuesday. Sophomores will meet Tuesday and Wednesday. And juniors will meet Thursday and Friday, I believe. You'll have about a week to fill that out. You want to make sure that your teachers are signing off on the courses that you're requesting. Your parents want to sign the sheet, and you want to sign the sheet. So when you meet with your guidance counselor, you want to make sure it's completely filled out. The other big thing is if you're planning on doing an AP elective, an AP class in the science department. So if you want to do AP biology, you want to make sure that your biology teacher is signing off. That's a new kind of thing that we're doing this year. So before, it had just been the previous teacher had to sign off of it. Now we want to make sure whatever the AP class you're taking, that teacher that you had for your honors or C1 class is signing off also.
That was interesting, but I'm probably still going to stay in TV.
While selecting your courses this week, kids, make sure you also donate to Coaches vs. Cancer. It's a good cause.
Let's find out more info on it.
Can you tell us a little bit about Coaches for Cancer?
Yeah, it's a fundraiser type thing where all proceeds go to the American Cancer Society. So the girls on the team as well as the boys team will be going out in the community, their family members, around the school and collecting donations. And all of those donations, all proceeds go straight to the American Cancer Society to hopefully find a cure.
The hockey program is selling these Coaches vs. Cancer cards. You raise money, it's a dollar each. Raise money for cancer research and then write your name on the card and we'll hang them up all over the rink just to raise awareness of cancer.
I believe it started with just the sport of basketball at the collegiate level, but now it's expanded all the way to any sport in college as well as any high school sport. We did it last year for the first time and it was a big hit. We sell little cancer cards. They cost a dollar, but you can give more money or a bigger donation for it. And we hang those up all over the rink Saturday night during our game. So it looks good when people walk in. We have banners and a lot of the parents volunteer to help out.
The hockey team's selling cards for cancer, and it's a great cause.
Well, that's all we have for this week.
I'm Derek, and that's Colin.
Good night, America.